ఆదిభ్యో బ్రహ్మ విద్యా సంప్రదాయ కర్తృభ్యో వంశ ఋషుభ్యో మహద్భ్యో నమో గురుభ్యః సర్వోపప్లవరహిత ప్రజ్ఞాన గణ ప్రత్యగర్థో బ్రహ్మాహమస్మి సోహమస్మి బ్రహ్మాహమస్మి. ఓం ప్రపన్న పారిజాతాయ తోత్ర వేత్రైక పాణయే జ్ఞానముద్రాయ కృష్ణాయ గీతామృతదుహే నమః. ఓం నమో వెంకటేశాయ. మై బెస్ట్ విషెస్ అండ్ పరిపూర్ణ ఆశీర్వాదంస్ టు ఆల్ ద వీవర్స్ ఆఫ్ శ్రీ వెంకటేశ్వర భక్తి ఛానల్. మే ద ఆల్ మైటీ శ్రీ లార్డ్ వెంకటేశ్వర బెస్టో ఆల్ కైండ్స్ ఆఫ్ ప్రాస్పరిటీ, హెల్త్, వెల్త్ అండ్ ఎటర్నల్ హ్యాపీనెస్ విత్ పరిపూర్ణ లక్ష్మీ కటాక్షంస్ టు యూ అండ్ ది ఎంటైర్ యువర్ ఫ్యామిలీ మెంబర్స్. లెట్ అస్ బిగిన్ శ్రీమద్ భగవద్గీత వర్స్ నంబర్ 14 ఆఫ్ 6th చాప్టర్. శ్రీ భగవాన్ ఉవాచ ప్రశాంతాత్మా విగత భీహి బ్రహ్మచారి వ్రతే స్థితః మనః సంయమ్యమచిత్తః యుక్త ఆసీత మత్పరః యుంజన్నేవం సదాత్మానం యోగీ నియత మానసః శాంతిం నిర్వాణ పరమా మత్సంస్థామధిగచ్చతి. భగవాన్ కృష్ణ హ్యాస్ డిస్క్రైబ్డ్ బాహ్య సాధనాస్ అండ్ దెర్ ఆర్ 8 కైండ్స్ ఆఫ్ అంతరంగ సాధనాస్ విచ్ బిగన్ విత్ దేశ, కాల, ఆసన, శరీరస్థితి, ప్రాణ సామ్యం, ఇంద్రియ నిగ్రహ, మనో నిగ్రహ, బుద్ధి నిశ్చయ. ఇన్ దిస్ 2 వర్డ్స్ హీ కన్ఫర్మ్స్ వాట్ ఇస్ మనో నిగ్రహం అండ్ బుద్ధి నిశ్చయం. ప్రశాంతాత్మ, అ మైండ్ విచ్ ఇస్ ఫ్రీ ఫ్రమ్ ఆల్ ద టెన్షన్స్, ప్రెషర్స్, డిప్రెషన్స్ అండ్ నాట్ ఓన్లీ దాట్ విచ్ ఈస్ నాట్ లాక్డ్ విత్ ఎనీ ఎమోషనల్ ఇంబ్యాలెన్స్. అ మైండ్ విచ్ ఇస్ పీస్ఫుల్ వితౌట్ ద లేయర్స్. వెన్ దెర్ ఇస్ లేయర్స్ ఇన్ ద వాటర్స్, వాటర్ కెన్ నాట్ బి seen as the crystal clear. Now the mind which doesn't have any kinds of variation or fluctuation, how it would be? The mind which is not loaded with the past, that is the mind. When you are loaded with past experiences, because mind has the tendency either to be endowed with the past or to be endowed with future. And past also is endowed with so many ups and downs, success and failure, imbalanced emotions, and that too always filled with omissions and commissions. I should have done this, I should have not done this, he should have not done this to me, I should have not done to that person. So these kind of fluctuations, and always we recollect, and that recollection brings irritation, guilt, tension, depression, and also sometimes you are not able to balance your emotions, you become very angry person. Now, when you want to become a meditator, we have to keep ourselves away our own past. Swamiji, how it would be possible? Because the man or personality, whoever I am, is because of the past. Yes, of course, past gives experiences. And we can learn a lot from our own experiences, but we should not taken carried away by those impact of negative experiences. Either we have to be like Annapakshi. Annapakshi is a swan which was mentioned only in the scriptures. It can just suck the milk, can leave the water. You have to become like Hamsa Pakshi, because nobody can help in this matter. whether you are grihastha, brahmachari, vanaprastha or sannyasi, you alone should deal or work with your mind to get away from the past impacts. That too, negative impacts, it won't go away. It will converted as the driving force for the future. That would make hell for you and people of you. When you have the responsibility of a family, you have the responsibility to make your mind with a standard qualities. You have to cleanse your mind from this negative impact that is very much needed for every day's life. Don't live in the past and don't live as the hangover person with the past. Every minute you have to rejuvenate yourself. That's what the quality, main quality between normal and successful people. Now Bhagavan Krishna says, when you sit for the meditation, you should have a mind which is endowed with nishchalatvam. Your mind should be like a crystal clear, and you should not carry all the loads of the past. For the time being, at least you be free from the past negative or positive impacts. You think about the mind. Sometimes we also feel that kind of mind. So mind, once you slept well in the night or in the daytime, you could feel and enjoy the mind which is endowed with Sattva-guna. That Sattva-guna mind is said by Krishna, it is suggested by Krishna, Nitya-sattva-stho-bhava, Nir-yoga-kshema-van-bhava. Nir-yoga-kshema-van means don't worry about even future. Now this Prashantatma, a person who is endowed with a mind loaded with Sattvika-guna, that mind becomes a boon for a spiritual or even materialistic prosperous. The mind, how can we get the mind is the best way to do japa. Take a mantra and continue with the japa and use Spatika mala, Rudraksha mala, Tulasi mala and lotus beads, whatever that you wish, you carry with that japa. Every japa will make you to be at present. Don't get it done mechanically. And be endowed with Lord. Every nama of Lord makes you to be endowed with the Lord. It's a beautiful method. You should set the patience in your mind, because when you sit for japa, your mind will bring all kinds of force and pressure on you to distract and deviate and express yourself in some other activity. Don't allow it. There you need to have resistance and you need to keep going continuously that process. Being peaceful minded, then you should become fear free minded too. That we have seen already in the last class. Fear free means not thinking about future. When you sit for the meditation, because mind is always filled with expectations even. Either the impact of the past or the expectation of the future, so both together called sankalpa vikalpatmakam manaha. The shastra, you know, it's friendly to our life. Every scriptures, every word of Bhagavad Gita, every word of all Upanishads, they are very friendly and a guide for you, for total humanity, to get along the samsara and to reach the moksha or Ishvara. Better we have to respect them, we have to utilize them. He says, Nir Yoga Kshema Atmavan, or there is a shloka in the 9th chapter, Ananyas Chintayanto Maam, Ye Janah Paryupasate, Tesham Nitya Bhiyuktanam, Yoga Kshemam Vahamyaham. Who always think about me, who always meditate on me, and who is dwelling or living only with my consciousness or my thought, who has surrendered to me, I will take care of all those life achievement, I will take care of all those karmas, karma phalas, and I will also take care of their present and past and even future. Yoga kshemam, material prosperous and spiritual prosperous, both will be taken care by me. That is the valid pramana and pratignya, and also a kind of promise from the Lord Himself. Therefore, you can continue as a prasantatma vigata bhihi, then brahmachari vrate sthitaha. A life which is committed or dedicated with a discipline. Now these words have got so many meanings, but here Brahma means Vedas or Vedanta. We also seen in the last chapter, in the 4th chapter, Karma Brahmodbhavam Vidhi Brahmakshara Samadbhavam Tasmat Sarvagatam Brahma Yajne Pratishthitam, Nityam Yajne Pratishthitam. Brahma means Vedas, a Brahmachari. When he is studying under a guru, for the time being, he is totally committed, surrender his life and all the efforts to the Vedas. Even he keeps his relatives away from his mind. Therefore, in those days, we had Gurukula system. How wonderful it is. Keeping away a student from the society, no impacts or no any kind of harmful things will happen to the students. Students is completely secure. How he was in the womb of mother, now he has come out, still he is in the womb of Guru and Shastra and Ishvara. Now when he surrenders to Shastra, he can find the Ishvara. When he could find the Ishvara with the help of Guru, that becomes a catch hold or some kind of holding for him to take his life further, to grow properly. At that time he has to temporarily keep himself away from the family called Brahmachari. Okay? And even when Grihastha means, there are two meanings. Literally it means, Grihastha means one who resides in home. We have to say one who resides at home or in house with the family. Or one more meaning, in whom the family, house or home resides. Everything exists in us. We are the people, we carry all the loads, even if all we want to go somewhere as a pilgrimage. We carry all the people, those people and events, incidents, accidents, they also travel without making or getting the tickets. We carry all of them. Bhagavan Krishna says, when you study Shastra, just let all the weight, the tons of weight, unload all the weight, become free. Like Janaka did with his guru. So when Janaka was sitting, then his guru said, the Mithila is on fire. He didn't move at all. He said, I am endowed with Shastra and Guru Ishvara. I don't care. I am a student of Vedanta. Then Vasishtha kept him as best, better and supermost student among all the students. Like that, temporarily you just surrender to the Brahman, the knowledge of Vedas. You have to be endowed with completely knowledge of Vedas. Then manas samyamya means having samyama. The word samyama, even it is explained a lot by Krishna in forthcoming chapters also, he will use the word. But Patanjali gives a proper word. All this dharana, dhyanam and samadhi together called samyamya. That is samyamam. Now manas samyamya means endowed with samyama. So samyama means it has to be on some object. Samyama is the activity, means the dharana means focusing, bringing together all the attention on one object. That object can be the subject, whatever it is. Now dharana means bringing all the attention together on something. Dhyana means becoming one with that something. Now if I make my object is Om, Om sound is an object for me, for my meditation. Oh, I'm bringing all the attention when I chant Om. Om, Om. Then I become one with the Om called Dhyanam. Then Dhyata, Dhyayam, Dhyanam becomes one. Then Samyama means, so that Om remains, I don't remain, just Om remains. All this together, when it happens with one object, it's known as Samyama. Now manas samyamya machittaha, that's what he says, you have to have samyama on me. He introduces the destination, he introduces the goal. Meditation should be endowed with the proper goal, because we do meditation in order to relax. That doesn't matter. If you are born in India, at least 5 minutes you should do meditation. Meditation is not merely thinking on something. It is not even living with the thoughts. It is a process. That process should have the proper direction. In order to have the proper direction, you should have fixed the proper goal. That goal always should be ultimate goal. God is nothing but ultimate goal. Forever, now or in the past, in the future, even after thousands of years later on, the God can be the first supreme destination or goal. You have to fix God as the goal. That is the highest standard of meditation. Highest standard means a best first quality of a meditator will fix God is the goal, because when he becomes one with the God, with the grace of God, he can gain whatever he want. If a person is endowed with ignorance, he alone fix some other worldly object as the goal. The worldly object will be endowed with what? Limitation of the time and space, time wise and space wise limitations that object will contain. Without knowing that, mind wants to fix that as a goal. But whatever the goal you fix, you will gain that. That is the nature of meditation. Therefore you have to be careful. You can fix your proper health as a goal, you can fix money as the goal, you can fix power as the goal, and you can fix also anima mahimadi, all these supreme superpowers as the goal. You will get definitely. But if you fix the goal, Ishvara is the ultimate one, just you become Ishvara, or Ishvara will become you, machittaha. Then matparaha yuktaha asitaha. You just try to bring samyama on me. That's what the shloka means. The next shloka he says, evam yun. Thus you keep continuing the meditation for how long? No limitation. Keep going, going. Don't worry about the fruit. But you have to be endowed with niyata manasaha. Sada atmanam yogi niyata manasaha evam yunjan. Mat samstham adhigachati. Nirvana paramam shantim mat samstham adhigachati. Beautiful words. You have to underline these words. They are very, very beautiful words. He attains, the person, one who fix me as the goal. It is very difficult, you know, when a mind is occupied with the fear, when a mind is occupied with the expectations, the mind will fix that particular object as the goal. But Bhagavan Krishna says, don't waste time. That's the wasting of the time, you know. If you fix a 10 crores is my goal, the mind which feels or values the money, because every one of us, we think money is everything. If I have the money, I can have my life according to my expectations. And after gaining that much of money, you can be a money meditator. No wrong in that, because Sanatana Dharma never controls. Money also we consider Lakshmi. Therefore, if you want to earn money in proper way, you are allowed. Nobody will deny. But it depends on your choice, your decision. You are the decision maker. You should be the responsible person for your future. Bhagavan Krishna says, you know, when you can think your money which is inert, jadam, as the goal, why can't you fix me as the goal? I am the author of all kinds of Aishwarya, Ashtaishwarya, Ashtalakshmi, Shodasalakshmi, even this Mahavishnu who is endowed with Lakshmi. That mind should have at least a small amount of punya to fix God as the goal. You know, that mind is known as prasadam, buddhi prasadam. When you get that prasadam, your mind will automatically fix the Lord is the goal. When you fix the Lord is the goal, he reaches a complete peaceful state. Nirvana paramam, that's what known as mokshaha. Mat samstham adhigachati. He reaches my place alone. Madhinam adhigachati. He reaches me alone. That is the prayojana as described by Bhagavan Krishna. This prayojana will be explained in the 18th chapter called Moksha Sannyasa Yoga. There we can see complete meaning of this Bhagavad Gita, means this word. You may think that Swamiji, 18th chapter is too long way to go. How long, you know, we may not have the memory of this word. Don't worry. Bhagavan Krishna brings again and again this concept, because he never leave any concept. He has got his own connectivity with his subject matter. We need not to get confused. Just we learn and enjoy the Bhagavad Gita, every verse, every chapter. So every part of Bhagavad Gita, which is Devamritam, that's called nectar, we will enjoy it and we'll also continue. I will see you in the next episode tomorrow. Harihi Om. ஓம் பூர்ணமத பூர்ணமிதம் பூர்ணாத் பூர்ணமுதச்யதே பூர்ணஸ்ய பூர்ணமாதாய பூர்ணமேவாவசிஷ்யதே. ஓம் சாந்தி சாந்தி சாந்திஹி. ஹரிஹ ஓம் ஸ்ரீ குருப்யோ நமஹ. ஹரிஹ ஓம்.